Grayson Hennig. It's Grayson's first year in hockey. His favorite player is Marc-Andre Fleury. He likes playing rolling and stopping pucks, being on the ice and shooting pucks around. Dislikes are getting tripped and hitting the post. Mr. Grayson Hennig, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight's player. And good evening, hockey fans. Welcome to the Forest Lake Sports Center for tonight's Suburban East Conference game between the Bears from White Bear Lake High School and the 2023 Forest Lake Rangers. And now here are our starting lineups, starting with White Bear. In goal, the senior number 33, Colin Thompson. On the blue line is a senior number 6, Joe Pallotta. His partner on the blue line is a sophomore number 10, Will Disco. That right wing is a junior number 14, Vincent Alella. Starting on the left wing is a junior number 3, Kevin Laska. And starting at center for the Bears is a senior number 16, Kyle Gibson. Head coach of the Bears is Mr. Tim Sager. And now for the Rangers, starting at goal, a junior number 1, Andrew Sachs. On defense is a senior number 13, Gavin Willie. His partner on the blue line is a junior number 24, Gavin Gaynor. At the right wing, a junior number 15, Caden Spidell. At left wing, a sophomore number 27, Malachi Kinnon. And starting at center for the Rangers, a junior number 44, Peter Bright. Assistant coaches for the Rangers are Matt Schumann, Chad Zine, and Christian Gaffey. The head coach is Mr. John Blue. Now if you please stand, face the American flag as the Rangers enter the arena and join us in the play of the Star Spangled Banner.
And we are live coming from the Forest Lake Community Center here And the Forest Rink Rangers have a tough team to face against White Bear Lake. They have been playing some excellent hockey these past few games. They are 4-2 on the season. Forest Lake still looking for their first win as they are 0-4 on the season. So they're looking to capitalize and clinch out their first win against a very tough team. And what do you think they can do to play a little bit more better hockey?
I haven't really been watching. I've only really seen a bunch of girls varsity, but boys, I feel like, at least from, I feel we had a defense and offense.
I feel like mainly we really got to work on defense, not letting up as many shots as we have these past few games, and maybe putting some more shots on goal. Both teams have a very rough time doing that. So
Rangers win the faceoff.
Gunnar Bright lined up for that faceoff there.
Six on White Bear.
As Rangers have it in the zone.
15. Dumps it down. 14 on White Bear. Passes it down. Try to make a pass to number three. Three going in on Ranger. Battling behind the net on the boards.
Rangers really trying to fight for the puck here in their own zone. Trying to get loose. Now number 19 having the puck. Gets flown into the air. 17 catches onto it. Number 3 grabs onto the puck, and that will be icing for White Bear. And it's going to White Bear's side at the faceoff. Now, against a very tough team, you would think that the Forest Lake Rangers really need to be on their A game today.
Yep. Number 2 passing it all the way down to 18. Almost a breakaway there, but he missed the puck. It's going to be icing.
Icing's the call. Goes back to White Bear's side. And we will see what happens in the faceoff as number 9, Nolan Road, facing off against the Rangers. And for the Rangers, number 22 facing off, that'll be Emma Cower. And looks like White Bear does win the faceoff, but is in their own zone because Rangers got it. Rangers battling it for it in their own zone. White Bear taking it out. 20 grabs the puck in the bottom left of the zone. Trying to get it away from others. White Bear fighting through. Looks like got a little shot in there, but wasn't very accurate.
Number 2 with the puck is going to pass that down. 9, lifted up off his stick in Rangers zone now.
Rangers really trying to get it out. They haven't been playing their best defense these last few games. They got to really be playing aggressive here.
Number 12 with the puck for White Bear. Going to pass that down, intercepted.
Right to a Rangers player, but couldn't really hang on.
Number 5 with the puck, going to dump that down.
Now the Rangers trying to battle for it in their own zone. Number 12 grabs on.
Number 5 for White Bear battling for the puck.
Number 13 trying to get that one there. That'll be...
Ooh, behind. That's going to be a penalty.
Gavin Lilly. And that's going to be a penalty.
That's going to be a crash check from behind.
And now... Rangers have a power play early here in this first period. You think they can put a goal up and get an early lead. Yes, exactly. Number 12 getting that penalty.
Aiden
Akins. Getting that penalty for the White Bear. Rangers trying to pass around. Gets a little hit. 44, Gunnar Bright.
Number 12 with the puck now.
Battling for it in their own zone.
Number 15 is going to pass it to 13.
13 passes. Passing back.
In front of the net. Loose puck.
He's in front of the net.
Here, number 12. Slap shot. Ooh, fanned on it.
And it's getting against the walls. Rangers trying to get the puck. Rangers found possession of the puck. Now, pass it. Bottom left. White Bear grabs onto it. Passes number 9. Number 9 racing down. Number 2 wide open. Goes, and he shoots and scores! Wow, a shorthanded goal for White Bear. That has got to be an upset there for the Rangers. You were not expecting that at all. Grady Gallatin getting
the
that
captain.
Goal.
One of the captains.
One of the captains for this team, and a very good team, especially. And one of those reasons is him finding a place to get open. Rangers win this faceoff. Going in the center of the ice, dumping it down. Rangers trying to fight for it in White Bear zone. Rangers trying to find an open lane. Couldn't find anything. Passes the puck. Fighting for it.
Dumps it down. Goalie's going to go by the net, and that's going to be an icing.
24 trying to catch that puck to stop the icing, but it was out of his reach.
No, it's a penalty. They can't be. I don't know what that was for.
Icing?
It's a penalty.
Number 14 lining up for this faceoff. That'll be Rangers grab the puck in their own possession. In their own zone. Passer.
Number 27 with the puck.
27, McKinnon.
Gonna dump that down to number 12.
Gunnar Bright trying to fight for the puck but doesn't get there.
Number
15, Cadence Fidel. Two on one. Passes in front of the net. Nobody there, though. Goes right to McKinnon. McKinnon trying to race across the left side, and that's going to be an offsides for the Rangers. And that will go back to the blue line. The faceoff. As number 17 lining up for this faceoff, Ellis Studier. And Rangers do win this faceoff.
Number 23 skating down and trying to get the puck.
Big hit across the boards.
Another
one.
Fighting for the puck on the boards. White Bear wins that. Number 12.
White Bear behind their net.
11. He's going to pass that to number 7. He's going to collide with number 2 on the Rangers.
Takes a shot. Ooh. Good block.
That's a nice save from the goalie. And number 11 with the puck now. Stealing it. Rangers. Oh. There's going to be a lineup change for the Rangers there. Forrest going to pass that down.
Rangers trying.
12's going to pass that down to 29. You can try to dump a Rangers interception. I mean, White Bear interception.
Right to White Bear. Gets tripped up a little bit, but no call. 11 having the puck. Skating around some players, trying to find
that.
A person. Number 10 takes a shot, hits the crossbar.
That was real close there.
That could have been a goal there. Up, that could have been up by 2, but it was intercepted. Number 6. Joe Beasley.
32 with the puck.
The Lazile.
And I think that went into the Rangers
bench.
Oh, yeah.
Goes in the Rangers bench, and that will be blown dead.
Face off in Rangers zone.
And your goalie today is Andrew Sachs, as he has been. He hasn't been. He's been an all right goalie, but has a troublesome defense, so taking a lot of shots, his save percentage is very good. But
44.
Unfortunately, they have lost every game so far this season. McKinnon trying to find the puck.
Number two on White Bear has the puck behind their own net. He could try to find someone open.
Grady Gallatin.
Pass it on, intercepted by Rangers, doesn't know where the puck is. Number 20, pass that on to 14.
Vinny Villiea. Big hits on the board.
Number 44 is trying to pass that to 15. He can escape that behind his own net.
15. Shoots.
Number 2 for White Bear has the puck now. He can pass that to number 20.
Rangers and White Bear trying to fight for the puck in the White Bear zone as they do escape. And that'll be dumped down. Oh, looked like White Bear almost took that puck there from Andrew. Got to be a little bit more careful.
Well, with a slap shot blocked by the goalie. 17 with the puck. White Bear with the puck now. Dangled. Blocked by the goalie. 22 is going to try to skate for that. And he spins out. 18, 9. Oh! Hits the crossbar.
That is two times White Bear's done that. And now it's a breakaway. Number 8.
Can he get the goal?
Doesn't get past him, but shoots again.
And he fanned
on it. Doesn't get it. Big hit. On White Bear's side. Wow, number 4 took a beating there. Noah Driscoll. Holy.
Number 13 skating in, Willie. He's going to try to dump that, but spun up.
Wow, that could have been a big opportunity for the Rangers, but just didn't connect there. On the faceoff, it's a 2-on-1.
6, passing it to 11. That's going to go in the corner.
That was Cole Rivard on that breakaway.
He's going to shoot, and it's going to be gloved by the goalie.
That was Cole Rivard on that breakaway, and he beat both those defenders, just split them across, and the goalie made a nice save there by the pads. He tried to take another shot, but unfortunately just hit the pads again. But that is their first shot of the night, and we are about halfway through this period.
White Bear wins the faceoff. Number 7 battling on the boards. Number 12 for Rangers is going to pass that on to 13. And White Bear is going to get that. Number 7 skating passes. Number 10 is going to shoot.
Nice
blocked
save.
By the goalie.
Nice save by Andrew there. Trying to get it, catch it by his glove.
Big
but
hit there.
Good thing it wasn't rebounded. Number 5.
Another huge hit.
Rangers playing very aggressive here in this first period.
Spun out.
Looked like 24 was trying to get that puck there, but tripped up. That was Gavin Gohner.
Number 27 has the puck. He's going to pass that on. He's going to be intercepted by White Bear, number 2.
And Spidell trying to fight for that puck there. Doesn't get it, though. McKinnon.
16.
Also trying to fight Rangers. Looked like kind of got tipped towards the goaltender. Makes a nice save, though. And it gets tipped up in the air.
7's going to dump that. Get a line change for White Bear.
Number 17 looks like trying to dump that. Looks like he got tripped up by one of his own teammates there.
Number 2 skating towards Rangers zone. It's going to be offsides.
White Bears been playing excellent today as they have already have 8 shots on goal and Rangers only have 1, not allowing much chances for the Rangers.
This is looking very similar to the other varsity game today.
Yeah, that was the girls' varsity game and they could not get much shots earlier today.
Number 14 with the puck is going to dump it, intercepted by a Rangers player. Number 20 for White Bear has the puck now. He's going to dump it. Sacks intercepted behind the net. Number 17 for White Bear is trying to get that puck. 20.
Dylan Buteau. And it goes in. What? Wow, Andrew Sachs looks like he's lost.
I'm not even sure what happened.
He was looking up like, where's the puck?
I think that was deflected.
Couldn't find it anywhere. Blake Erickel gets that goal for White Bear. And let's see this replay as looks like they take a shot and just gets past him.
Wow.
You couldn't really see the puck at all.
Yeah, I didn't even know where it was. I thought it was deflected in. Face off in center ice.
Andrew Sachs was looking up at disappointment there. Could not find the puck at all. That's a good screen by White Bear. As Rangers do have it in the White Bear zone. Trying to get past some defenders.
Number 24, trying to get that puck. Number 9, White Bear has the puck, spins out past that to number 18. He's going to shoot that out. It's going to be caught. 18 with the puck. He's going to skate down. He's going to pass it on to 9. He's going to shoot in the
score.
In. Wow, off the crossbar.
Wow, he did the little no-look there. It looked like he wasn't even going to shoot, but just surprise, surprise. Takes a shot on the top right, hits the crossbar, and they will be up by 3 early in this third period. Getting that goal was number 9, Nolan Rowig. As the goalie looked pretty surprised there as Andrew does stay in, but not sure how long, if he keeps playing like this, is going to stay in. They might have to bring up some of the backups. As McKinnon trying to race for the puck.
That's going to go flying into Rangers zone. Thurston's going to try to get that.
Both teams trying to find the puck.
McKinnon trying to get that puck, but it's being fought off by number 6. Number 6 has the puck. He's going to pass that on to number 11.
11 now. On the left side, takes a hit.
27.
Trying to take a little shot there, but doesn't get it anywhere. This is going to be a long day for the Rangers if they keep playing like this. As they already have 10 shots within not even the half of the first period.
And Rangers only have one, not much time in the offensive zone. Number 15 for the Rangers, skating behind his own net. He could try to pass it on to number 27.
As McKinnon tried to get that puck, but just doesn't get it. Hit the bars there, huh? Hit the glass there.
14 skating into Rangers zone. Over. Tried to juke out number 8, I believe, number 9. Corny's going to take a wrist shot. Blocker save by Sachs.
That'll be the 11th shot on goal for the White Bear. And now you're looking at that breakaway earlier today, and we're really wishing they scored there because they only have one shot, and that was that. And that'll be a face-off on White Bear's side. 4 minutes and 30 seconds left in this first period. Not a very good first period for the Rangers. Hopefully they can improve. As the Rangers passing down to the bottom left, trying to get some players in. Passing around. McKinnon takes a shot. Doesn't get anywhere.
So, 20 with the puck. He's going to dump that down in Rangers zone. 13 passes on. 22 deflected by a White Bear player.
Number 13 trying to fight for the puck.
Number 12. He's going to pass it back on to 4. As 4 skates into center ice. In Rangers zone, he's going to try to pass it. Number 8 shot.
Good save there by Andrew.
As we have a face-off in Rangers zone.
And looks like the Rangers are battling for it in their own zone in the bottom right of the corner.
Number two, trying to get that hit from behind.
Somebody trying to find the puck. Number four gets it on Mike Bear's side, though, and that'll be a penalty for Mike Bear.
Nolan Rode with that penalty. It's going to give the Rangers a power play.
Going to give them a chance to score there. They really need this, especially now since they have three scores early in this first period.
Not what you want to see.
They really need to be taking advantage of this power play and having possession of the puck. As McKinnon is going to be lining up for the faceoff.
McKinnon and Aiden Welch. Rangers win that, but it's intercepted.
Gunnar Bright couldn't reach it. It's a one-on-one. Eight beats him. Takes a shot. Wide left of the net. Very close there. Almost another shorthanded goal on the Rangers.
27 is going to pass it on to number 12. As he passes that back to number 13.
Back.
12 is trying to fight off two players. McKinnon pokes that out to 44 as 44. Passing that on to number 15. He skates out. Pass it to 27. He shoots.
Gets blocked.
Wind up. Faked out.
Doing a little fake slap shot there. Back to McKinnon. Doesn't get possession of it, though. Fight for in the bottom left, and that is going to be dumped down to the Rangers side. As McKinnon now having the puck but loses it. Grabs onto it again. Trying to get it. Trying to pass towards other teammates.
Number two for White Bear with the puck. He's going to pass it on. Number 11 tries to get that, but it's swatted away. Number two back with the puck. Fighting off McKinnon. Hit. And that's going to be another penalty.
That's going to be a 5-on-3 for the Rangers now. They have to be taking advantage of these. They need to score quick. They can get two quick goals. That would be very nice for the Rangers.
Number two, Grady Gallantine.
Rangers making some line changes.
Face off in White Bear zone. Play is blown dead. McKinnon and Aiden Welch. No, I'm sorry. Nolan Rowe for that faceoff.
As Rangers are just passing around, trying to find for an open lane, as you expect.
Number 13 with the puck. Gonna pass that back to number 12 with the 13 with the puck. Shoots.
Makes a shot and it gets past him. Score!
Top right shelf.
It'll be back to a 4-on-5, but that was what we needed exactly.
Gavin Willie.
Gavin Willie getting that goal.
Top right shelf.
That is a big goal there. Now we have a 1:35 power play. Can we get another goal? We're really taking advantage of that 5-on-3, and we just beat the goalie. That's a good play by the Rangers to make this game 2-point differential now. As White Bear does win the faceoff in their own zone, trying to pass, doesn't connect. Dumps it down in the Rangers zone. Now McKinnon grabbing the puck. Off to the races. He goes left side. On the middle of the ice. Gets past the offensive zone. Trying to find teammates, but doesn't do anything. Fighting for it in the left of the ice.
Number 12 for White Bear. Trying to get that puck. Pass it down to number 9. He's caught up. He's going to pass that down. Number 20 trying to get that. Fighting for it. Number 12 with it again. He's going to pass it on to number 9. And 9 skates down center ice. In the corner. Fighting for that puck.
40 seconds left on this period.
And Rangers
almost really fighting for it in their own zone.
27 with it. Passes it down to number 12.
33 seconds left on the power play.
He's going to pass it.
Going to be in the
finish. Tries to pass it to 8, but here at number 12 back.
White Bear just trying to bring this into the second period. Let's see what Ranger can do.
22 is going to pass that to 44.
Tried to go to 15, but doesn't do anything. Kind of tipped it up a little bit. Now White Bear, it's a 3-on-3 in their own zone.
They shoot blocked by the goalie.
Andrew Sachs tried to catch it, but...
And that's going to be the end of the first period.
That'll be the end.
Still 3 seconds left in the penalty.
Don't really think that'll be too much. But White Bear up by 2 points. It is 3-1. Rangers really need to step up their game here, really step up their defense on being having some more awareness, I feel. Because the goalie kind of was lost on some of these shots, and we don't really want that. As the Rangers only have 2 shots in this first period, and White Bear has 13. And we'll be seeing you in the second period.
Here we are, back in the second period. White Bear leading by two, and the Rangers with a 3-second power play.
Yeah, and that last power play became a goal for the Rangers at the very end of the first period.
I mean, statistically, if you think about it, their goalie has a .5 save percentage. Two shots, one goal. But
you mean 50%?
No, I say like 500. .5.
.5.
They say .500. I feel like the Rangers need to get some more goals here. They need more goals, but more shots. They only have two shots on goal, while White Bear has 13.
Yeah, we were saying this earlier today. We were watching the girls' varsity game. Actually, we were announcing it. And these two teams have some very similar problems. They don't really get enough shots on goal.
Yeah.
As Gunnar Bright faces off.
Number 27 is going to dump that down, and he's going to keep that gloved.
And he covers it up, and this will be a face-off in White Bear's side.
Colin Thompson, the goalie for White Bear this period.
Looks like to be the backup goalie of this team.
24, huge hit there. Number 13 is going to smartly dump that down.
Now 20 fighting for the puck. Passing it to 11. 11 trying to go. Passing it to his teammates. Rangers kind of get a stick in there. Trying to fight for it. It's a one-on-one. 11 having the puck. Takes a shot wide left. Now Rangers having the puck. Skating down the ice. Let's go of it to do a line change.
White Bear number 20 behind the net. He's going to wait here.
Waiting for an open player.
He's going to pass that all the way down to number 7.
Number 7 doesn't connect though.
It down. Number 13 skating down towards center ice. Passes that to number 21. But he can't.
Wyatt Saltness kind of disconnected that pass.
Number 5 here skating.
Noah Norman.
Number 10 dumps that down. Number 8 here trying to dangle around. Number 22, Howard. He's going to pass that down to number 8, but he can't connect to it. But he connects to a different. Ooh, huge hit behind the net there. Number 8 on White Bear.
Playing very aggressive in this team.
That might be a penalty. Number 8, that's a penalty. Number 8, Aiden Welch. Pretty sure that's going to be a hit from behind.
As White Bear has had a lot of penalties in this game so far, and they've allowed one goal by them. That 5-on-3 and that breakaway in the first period could have been very clutch for them, but didn't get that. Rangers still only have two shots.
Oh, breakaway, number 9.
Number 9 off to the races. Get past him and he scores.
Number 9, Nolan Rode.
Nolan Rode was not going to let that happen. He did not want to waste that opportunity, and he used it right. He crushed that puck into the net, and he got all of it.
Just beats Andrew Sachs there through the 5-hole. Face off at center ice.
Shoots right in between the legs and just crushes it. Now White Bear up by 3 again.
Hits the ref. He's down. Number 9 back with the puck. He's going to go for the net, and that's going to be stopped by Andrew.
Good cover up there by Andrew.
Check if the ref's good there. His skate's messed up, probably.
He's going to feel that one tomorrow.
Face off in Ranger zone. Number 18, Jack. And I believe that's number 14, 44.
Rangers won this face off.
Right
turn on the net.
Intercepted number
trying
9.
To pass around. White Bear having the puck. Number 6 passes to number
2. Number 9. Number 9 has been really physical this game. A lot of hits from seeing from him.
Number nine is physical, and he is very fast, as we saw.
Yes.
On that breakaway, he was speeding down that ice.
Into the rafters, and it was caught. We saw the other game as well.
In the girls' varsity game, the puck launched up in the air into the rafters and wasn't caught, though.
Face-off in Rangers territory.
Rangers do still have a power play here, but kind of forgot about it already since they scored again on a shorthanded goal. Rangers trying to find an open man in the back of their net. Number two.
24.
Number 24.
He's going to skate that to the center ice, pass it to 27, but can't connect on it. Their goalie's going to go for that. Passes it behind. 24, skating.
Trying to find
behind
somebody. Looks like they're wasting their own power play.
27.
McKinnon having the puck, trying to fight it.
Number 10. Penn with the puck now. Passes it on to number 11.
Nice little poke check there.
27 skating
now
down.
Now McKinnon, a dangerous player.
Passes
out to the center.
Oh.
Shoots wide right, though.
Yeah, number 12 with the puck. 15 seconds left in the power play. Hauer could not connect with the puck there.
Takes a hit on the edge of the ice.
21 with the puck. Going to pass it on number 12. Skating around. Pass it to number 21. 20 has it now. Pass it to 4. 4 here, dump that down. Now number 3. Skating at center ice. Cannot connect with the puck, though. Here number 13. He's trying to get that puck for the Rangers. 17. Swats that away. 20 takes a shot. Blocked by Sachs. 20. He's going to dump that down to number 13. And intercepted. And that's going to be
so many shots on the Rangers. 18 shots for White Bear.
Wow.
This is incredible.
Isn't that-
this is in our last game, the girls' Vardy City game, they had like 54 shots. On.
Rangers really need to get some more shots here. I mean, only two shots.
Both these teams are kind of looking identical, to be honest.
Not a single shot this period. Number 10 is going to skate down and try to get that one. It's going to be icing. And there's going to be a face-off in Rangers zone.
Rangers really need a goal here to catch up with White Bear, as this is a very tough team. They do not want to let them play conservative. Rangers need to play more aggressive and get some more hits in. Rangers looking like they're going to win this face-off as White Bear gets it in their own zone. Number 6, Joe Beasley.
Going to pass that on to number 18. Now number 8 with the puck, and that's going to be offsides.
As we've seen a lot of penalties on White Bear, but not a lot of scores for Forest Lake, as they were literally wasting their own time in their own zone. So, yeah, that's about how that goes, but that is okay. As this Rangers is very aggressive.
Number 9 is going to try to fight that away from number 12. Passes it on number 10. It's 10. Passes it on the 6. He's just getting Rangers zone.
Passes it back.
Blocked, I'm pretty sure, by number 12. Number 12 with the puck now. He's going to pass it on to 27.
And we got a 2-on-2. Trying to pass to his teammate, but doesn't really get there.
Couldn't connect as 8 blocked that. Oh, in front of the net and couldn't connect. Oh!
In front of the net again, but McKinnon couldn't grab onto it as they played excellent defense there. Number 6, I believe, got that puck.
27, McKinnon has the puck.
We've heard
dumps that.
We've heard their name a lot.
That's. Oh, I thought that one in there.
Trying to fight for the puck. Getting past 1. Could have got there. Looked a little winded after that.
He needs a line change. Number 9 is going to pass it on 11. 11's going to shoot, and that's wide above the net. 2 with the puck now. Pass it on a 20.
Grady Gallatin.
Fought out by the first 21. Goal. 20 with the puck.
Didn't
He's
pass.
Pass it on. Number 5. Swatted away by number 13. And that is
Noah
shot
Norman
off.
Had that puck there, but just got let go of it, and it'll be on the right there side.
Passed on. 29. Now 24. Passed it on 8, but that is swatted off, and that's going to be icing.
Rangers have yet to shoot the puck in the second period on goal. And as we're going to see here, that pass that got a little bit miscontrolled. Looks like both players could have had a chance there to shoot on net, but neither of them could hold on to it and get a shot off.
Will Dilstad with that great defense for the White Bear.
Harper's been playing excellent offense, playing very aggressive as Rangers have the puck.
Skating shot wide above the net.
Good block there.
24 is going to try to pass it, but White Bird intercepts that. Number 3, skate on.
Trying to look for his teammates on the left side, but nobody there.
Number 29 with the puck behind his own net. It's going to pass on to 25 before it catches that. 24, he's trying to get that out of there. Now number 23 is trying to pass that, but it is thrown into White Bear zone. 4 with the puck, passes it to number 12. 12's going to pass that to number 18. Skating fast into Ranger zone. And as he's tripped up, but there's no call. Shot into the netting. This play's going to be called dead.
Rangers have not been playing particularly well in this second period, as they've had no shots on goal, but very close to one, as they've had that 2 miscompleted passes there. Really need those to count. As Nolan Rowid and number 12 facing off.
Battling for the puck on the boards. Number 27 with the puck is going to pass it to number 15. Has a huge hit there. Number 10 with the puck. Pass it along the boards. Goalie with the puck now is going to pass that on. 12 passes it to 15.
Rangers have the puck in their own zone, trying to get rid of it. Passing, miscompleted. It could have been a breakaway, but McKinnon tripped up.
And they're going to hold on to that.
As White Bear has been playing excellent today, as they've had 4 goals on Rangers and 19 shots on goal.
Face off in White Bear zone.
Looks like Rangers do win it, battling for it, but White Bear gets it.
Ooh, huge hit there.
Rangers trying to get rid of it in their own zone. 11 really fighting for that one.
Number
dumps it down the bottom left.
Lots of big hits in this game. As we saw in the junior varsity game with some fights. Number 5, skating shot, loved by Sachs. I'm pretty sure that's going to be the 20th shot on goal for White Bear.
They have 18 more shots than the Rangers, as the Rangers cannot get it on the offensive side. But they have been playing very well at keeping it out of the net, I suppose you can say. If you have 20 shots and 4 goals. But definitely need to work on that defense and try and not get as many shots.
Number 13 Gonna pass that to number 17. Two on one.
Has an open
shot.
Man, but decided to take it himself. And it looks like to be a wrong decision there by the Rangers. As he saw the chance, and that'll be offsides. See that again.
Face off on the blue line. Number 12 and number 18, I believe. 16. He's gonna pass that on. 15 with the puck now. He's trying to get it. We can't. Coming off the bench, number.
Rangers really trying to fight for the puck. Pass it to number 15. Take a shot.
Wow.
Goalie
sliding
gets
save.
There. Wow, what a save.
And a hooking call, I believe, on the Bears, White Bear.
Colin Thompson makes a great save there. The puck got loose, and it was going everywhere, but didn't really get it.
And
it deflected off, and McKinnon looked like had a shot.
Wow.
But reaches the leg out.
Aiden Akeens with the penalty here. Another chance for the Rangers goal. That's going to be dumped. Oh, into the boards.
And that'll be back on White Bear's side.
Number 15.
Caden Spidell.
Facing off against number 9. Nolan Rode. Number 2 here. The captain. Passing it on, but can't. Number 15. Hit from behind. Battling for the puck on the boards. Trying to get this playoff started.
Makes a nice little save. Trying to get it out.
Here, number 12 here, passing it on to number 13. As 13 is trying to bat off number 9, he tries to pass it, but it is caught by number 2. 44 with the puck.
Now White Bear grabs onto it, number 8. Gives it right back to the Rangers. McKinnon passing. Number 12. Number having the puck, passes. Number 13 trying to grab that one. Takes a hit on the boards. And there will be a line change for White Bear.
Number 44 with the puck. It's passing on the 27.
McKinnon grabbed onto it. It's a 1-on-4. Waiting for his teammates, trying to stall and get some time. 42 seconds left on the power play for the Rangers as they have not had had a penalty yet in this game. Big hits on the side of the boards.
He's going to dump that. 29, battling 20. 20 with the puck. Tried to do a wraparound but couldn't. Ooh, big hit there.
A lot of hits in this game. Very aggressive.
24, trying to pass that but blocked. Oh,
that's going to be a tripping call.
A hooking, I believe. That might be slashing.
Whatever it is number 11, and that'll be 2 minutes on the box as they will have a 5-on-3 for about 3 seconds.
Brady Borgstad. Number 22 for the Rangers. Emmick Hauer facing off with number 9. Dumping that. Goalie's going to try to pass it on to Willie. As 24 gets it, he's going to pass that back to number 13. 13's getting up to center ice. Could it connect, though, with number 6 with the puck? He's going to decide to dump that. It is not successful. Number 8 passing that on.
24. Back to 24. passing it all around, trying to find a lane. 24 passes.
24 back with the puck. Number 13, 12, deflected onto the boards, and that's going to be dumped onto the net. Saxy decided to pass that to 13, Willie. Willie passed that on, and that is deflected off the boards. 2 dumps that. Passes that. Tries to pass it to 21, but can't connect. It's another dump.
As Forrest Lake trying to get around White Bear, they are both fighting. McKinnon passing. Trying to find somebody. Back to McKinnon. Takes a shot under the legs.
Oh.
Right under number 10's legs. That was a kind of surprise play by McKinnon there. Just kind of crouched under there and took a shot right on net. But makes a nice save.
27, McKinnon facing off with, can't see his number.
It's a good glove save there by Colin Thompson.
Nolan Rode faced off. Number 2 passing that on to number 8. Now to number 9, skating up the right boards. He's going to dump that, dump and chase. Back with the puck. White Bear really fighting for that. Rangers with the puck now. 27. Off the boards. 15. And it's going to be icing. Couldn't catch up to it.
Not a lot of success on this Rangers team so far, as they've only had 5 shots in this game.
Face off in Rangers zone, number 9 and number 17, I think.
That'll be Nolan Rode and McKinnon on the face off.
2 trying to pass that, 20 with the puck now. Going to pass it on to his captain.
About 3 minutes left in this period.
18 with the puck. He passes it on number 9. Breakaway here. Blocked by Sachs. Nice save. Another save.
Good rebound there by the players. Great awareness by Andrew Sachs to catch it.
Shoots. Oh, it's loose.
Andrew trying to cover that up. A lot of commotion going on.
And it is covered by Sachs.
What a great save there by Sachs. Couldn't really see much, but since he was very crowded, but he got it. As
that's one of the worst things when you're a goalie, to have that puck loose in front of you and you're on the ground. Only thing you can hope for is that it doesn't go and your teammates get swatted away.
Goalie was laying there trying to get some arms out, trying to get it in his glove, and luckily he does.
Face off in Rangers zone. Rangers win it, 21. Trying to get that puck. 4 with the puck now for White Bear. He's going to pass it to number 12. 12. Ooh! Rangers intercept that but can't make the shot connect. 12 back with the puck on number 4. Get past that. To number 14.
Take the big hit!
And that's going to be a penalty.
He's going to be charging. As that'll be 21 for the Rangers, as that is their first penalty today in this game. Wyatt Saltness. So let's see what this power play unit, power kill unit, can do for the Rangers. As
number 9 and number 17 back on the faceoff in Rangers zone. Now it's on to number 8. Rangers bats it away. Number 2 with the puck now. He's passing it on to number 6. On to number 9. Back to 6. Back to 9.
Just kind of playing catch around.
shoots, and it's a goal off the crossbar.
Not a lot happening, really, and Nye just gets a lucky shot, gets through a lot of players, and that's going to be a goal for six.
The first 16 seconds of the power play, there's a goal by their captain, number six.
Six and nine were both just passing to each other.
Playing catch.
Finally just tries to take a shot and beats Andrew Sachs.
Face off of center ice. Battling for in the middle, number seven, chasing for it.
Devin Willett making that puck loose.
Number 11 trying to pass out on number 10. Who doesn't get it? 15 intercepts. It's going to be a 2-on-2 here.
15 trying 44. To pass out on 44. It's going to be offsides.
Dead.
Play was blown dead, and that'll be back on the blue line.
Minute and 43 seconds left here in the second period. Huge shot difference. Five shots for Rangers, 25. For White Bear. Rangers win this faceoff. They're going to dump it to number 10. Number 10 passes to 6 but can't connect. Fighting for it on the boards here. Here we have 24 making a shot. Can't connect. 27 trying to get this puck. He's going to pass it to number two. Two's going to pass it on to
trying to 24. Pass it on, trying to find an open lane where they take a shot, but not really much happening there as White Bear does get it.
Number 10, 1 minute left in the second period.
15 grabs on it, takes a shot.
Nice blocker save there by the White Bear goalie. Eric Knees.
Looks like McKinnon was a little bit trapped there. In White Bear zone as number 15 just dumps it down in the bottom right. And there'll be 40 seconds left in the second period. White Bear looking to just waste some time. As White Bear is still up by 4.
And that's going to be offsides.
Going to go back to the blue line.
Hauer facing off with number 9. 8 trying to get that puck, but can't. Ooh, nice save there by that goalie.
Andrew Sachs.
22 skating up, shot over the net.
14 seconds left in the second period.
Oh, breakaway number 9. Amazing pass. And that goalie makes an amazing
wide
sliding
left.
Blocker save. And that is going to be it for the end of the period. That's a bit of a late shot there. It's going to cause some...
Whoa. A little bit of aggression going on with both of these players. Looks like number 22 really getting in their face.
I mean...
Number 8.
Really, what did he expect? That was a pretty late shot there.
As they're sorting things out.
I mean, when you're losing by 4 in the second period, it's going to cause some anger.
Definitely, for sure, especially at this Rangers place, and not looking good so far in the second period as they are down by 4. White Bear been playing excellent. They've had so many shots, 26 at the end of the second period.
A 20-shot difference in only the second period.
That's pretty crazy, but we'll see what the Rangers can do in the third period. We'll see you then. Thank you.
All right, hockey fans, it's that time to chuck your puck. We're going to have a cash prize, the closest to the center ice guy, and then closest to the four pizza box will be a gift certificate to Chanticleer Pizza. Rock and roll, here we go. higher penalties were assessed at the end of the second period at the 17-minute mark. First, the Forest Lakes number 22, Aaron Powell, and the White Bear Lakes number 8, Andy Elch. Court received 2-minute penalties for roughing. Again, both of those penalties were at the 17-minute mark. Rough for the Rangers, rough for the Bears, Powell for the Rangers, both for roughing. Reminder, Ranger fans, our next home game will be this coming Tuesday evening as the Rangers take on St. Francis in a non-conference game. The JV game gets underway at 5 o'clock, followed by the varsity game at 7. It will be senior night, and immediately following the varsity game will be honoring the 7 Rangers senior athletes. So please hope to see you here on Tuesday night. Tuesday the 20th, the Rangers and St. Francis here at the Sports Center at senior night. Game times are 5 and 7 p.m.
And welcome back to the Forest Lake White Bear matchup. White Bear is up by 4 in the third period. Rangers looking for 4 goals or more, and they do not need any more goals on them.
Nope.
And more shots. Let me tell you.
Some more shots here.
Some more shots. They've had 6 shots. I think they've done a little bit worse than the girls, but I feel that the boys really need to step this one up and get some more shots on goal and put them in the net.
Yep.
First of all.
I completely agree with you. Some more shots, some less shots on Rangers' goal. And less shots on Rangers' goal, more shots on Red Bear. Face-off starting number 5. Sorry. Wrist shot into the netting. It's stuck in the net.
It's fine.
Face off. 27 was trying to get it, but was caught. Number 10 here with the puck. Wrist shot, wide right. Ooh, trying to get a wraparound.
And puck. The net comes loose.
I almost said puck.
The puck comes loose. But the net did go loose. And the play will be blown dead, and it will be a face-off on Rangers' side again. As we have not left the Rangers' side in this third period yet.
Looking like it's going to be number 5 starting to face it for White Bear, number 8, I believe, for Rangers.
As all these players line up, the Rangers do win this face-off.
8, you're trying to get that blocked by 10, slips. 8.
And 8 takes it.
6 caught that, though. 5 skating in the Rangers' zone. Dumped behind net. 6 with the puck now. Back to five. Pass that. Ooh, that might be high sticking. That might be high sticking there.
The ref's talking about it.
Kind of like a Z-grass goal there.
All three of the refs, the goalie wants high sticking.
That is close. Let's see that.
See the replay. Gets passed.
That might be good. That might be good.
I think it just got tipped up and he hit it down. And this will be a goal. I believe it is a goal.
No, it's no goal. No goal. No goal. I mean, it's a close call. It can be called either or, but
it is
good
not
for the Rangers.
And the goal is waved off, and this will start on White Bear's side. Number 44 lining up, Gunnar Bright, loses that faceoff. Now Rangers have possession in their own zone. Number 3 trying to race for that one.
And I didn't realize there are two players on each side in the box. I'm guessing for that roughing at the end of the game, that little fight after that late shot. Captain, and I'm pretty sure that's 22 in there for Rangers.
Yeah, that should be over in about 36 seconds or so. They'll come back in. But both teams are still at full strength.
Rangers face off, number 9. And 17, I believe. White Bear wins that, number 2. Pass on 28, dumps that. Caught in the skates of 17.
Oh, misconnected pass there. Could have been big.
Ooh, 23. Back to the puck after it. Slam into the boards.
Number 17.
Battling for the puck.
Trying to fight for the puck.
3 with the puck now. He's going to pass it on to number, the captain, number 2. And that's going to be dumped. But caught by 4. That's some head collision there.
Number 4 takes a hit on White Bear's side. Noah Driscoll.
That's kind of dangerous. Number 2.
Now the puck.
For the puck.
Puck on
He's
White Bear's
pass
side.
That on to number 17.
Gets past 1. 2 to beat.
Ooh.
Trying to take a little shot there. Doesn't get it.
That's going to be dumped. And that's going to be icing. Oh.
This will be icing for the Rangers, and both players do come out of the box. So now nobody in the box, and face off on Rangers' side as Andrew Sachs is still in front of the net. Maybe consider doing a little goalie change up at the end of the game. Nothing going on right now,
though.
Some
lineup confusion.
As number 11 coming out, that'll be Brady Borgstad, as he is a captain for one. He's one of the captains.
Passing that on number 4. As 4 passes that back to 14. Can't connect, though. 29 with the puck. Passes it to 24. 4 with the puck for White Bear. Skating along the left side of the board. He's going to pass that. Trying to pass it to 14, but 29 intercepts. 29 back with the puck. He's going to pass that. 11, trying to get the puck there. 29, passing that to 18. And a whistle for, I'm guessing, a hit there.
Looks like the Rangers will be going in the box. Number 8. That will be Cole Rivard in the box currently. And now it'll be a power play.
This is not what the Rangers want right now. Number 9 and number 27 facing off in Rangers zone. 27 back at the puck. He's going to dump that. He's going to be successful onto the net. Number 6 here with the puck. He's skating up. Passes that to number 9. 9 skating fast into Rangers zone. Big hit there. Blocked.
Still hangs onto the puck though, going around the net. Trying to find somebody. And the whistle is blown dead. Looks like the net got a little bit loose there. So they're fixing it right now. And White Bear having a power play. 1 minute and 33 seconds left. Let's see if they can score and make this lead even further. Rangers need a lot to go their way here in this last period. And so far, nothing has been going on. Except for that waved off goal.
Number 2 behind his own net with the puck. He's going to skate that out and pass it to number 6. Number 6 skates it, tries to pass it to 8, but it deflects into the boards. Number 6 passing out on number 2. 2 tries to get a deflection in front of net, but doesn't go the way he wants to.
A minute left on the penalty for Rangers. Rangers just trying to get it out of their zone for the life of them.
Another dump. Passing that. Number 18, I believe, with the puck. Ten stops that from getting thrown in their zone.
Ten, passing it to number 8. Passing back to number 12. Back to 10. Back to 12. Passing. 15. Gets a stick on it. Now they're off to the races for the puck. Looks like the goalie let go of it in front of the net. 15 trying to fight for the puck. Two players. White Bear grabs onto it again. Number 10 passing to 11. 11 trying to race for it. And it'll be covered up by the goalie.
The boy's gonna hold
Andrew
on
Sachs.
To that.
And Rangers are back at full strength.
21 shot difference here. The Rangers are really going to need a miracle to tie this game up at least.
Yeah, they cannot allow any more goals to go in their net, and they got lucky on that other goal that got waved off. Fighting for the puck in the back of the boards.
7, take a shot. Nice glove save there by Andrew Sachs.
You do wonder if they bring one of the backup goaltenders in just to see what happens. Eric Nyes has played once, and that was, I believe, last game they've played. And he came in at the third period and allowed a couple of goals. So we'll see. White Bear, number 5, having the puck, just dumps it down on the bottom right. 11, trying to grab it on the puck. Number 4, trying to pass, doesn't get anywhere. Number 5, kind of deflects it. Number 12, now getting in, passes Barry back to White Bear. Nothing really going on, just passing around. Number 11, trying to fight for the puck, goes back to number 12. Number 12 hits it up to number 7. Number 7, trying to fight for the puck. 5, in a battle, just tips it away. Trying to bring that up and out of their zone. Number 12 brings it back. As maybe a little bit of a line change.
Ooh.
Takes a shot.
Blocker shot.
It's loose. In front of the net, and nice save.
Play is blown dead, and I believe
Colin Thompson got onto it. And there will be no penalty, but very lot.
That's real close there.
Yeah, puck got loose in the back and just got hit away, and the play was blown dead. Looked like.
Number 20 here with the puck. He's going to pass that, but can't connect. Kind of a hit there. 20 with the puck. Tries to pass it back. As 2 has the puck. gonna try to pass, and that's gonna go in to the White Bear bench. Face off at center ice, number 16 and number 44.
Gunnar Bright taking this face off for the Rangers.
Rangers win.
24 grabs onto it, dumps it down.
20 here now with the puck. He's going to pass it on number 2. 2 passes it into the boards as number 16 had that puck. 27, McKinnon dumps that. Now number... Ooh, in front of the ice. And...
goal for the Rangers!
Wow! Nice shot there. Nice passing.
Very unexpected late in this third period, but he got it.
With just a little under 10 minutes left, can the Rangers get this game back?
It looks like that was...
Here
that was 17. A nice shot. Beat the goalie.
27, McKinnon. With that shot there. Nice passing there.
That's gonna bring you a little bit excited, yeah?
Get the crowd back moving. Hopefully the players bring some life into them, get another goal.
Yeah, it was very,
Whoa! 27, again with another shot and a close goal, but just off the left post.
Wow, we might have saw some light going on.
I mean, that's gonna bring something to the Rangers. Hopefully, get them pumped up.
It's gonna bring some boosted, eh?
22. That's gonna be blown off sides.
Wow! All of a sudden,
that was real close.
These last 30 seconds, Rangers are doing some, getting some shots on, and looks like McKinnon. It wasn't McKinnon. It was somebody else, but he took a shot right in front of the net.
Howard,
and it got blocked.
13, Willie with the puck. Gonna pass it on to 21. 6 for White Bear now has the puck. Tries to pass it, but intercepted by number 2. Fighting on the boards, number 6 with the puck. Gonna pass that to number 10. 10, skating up on Ranger zone, pick a shot.
And that'll be offsides.
Still a nice blocker save by Sachs.
Now this game is only, you're only down by 3. You got 9 minutes left. You got to see some hope. You can't allow another goal. It's not acceptable right now. You need to get your offense going.
Fighting on the blue line. 3, trying to get that puck, but Howard gets it.
Kind of does a little hop.
Wow.
Number 22.
I believe that's Howard. I think Howard. Takes a shot, gloved by the goalie.
This goalie has been great
Bolin
tonight.
Thompson.
As he has made so many saves. 22 is kind of just jumping over players.
Nice dangle there, but can't connect to get a pass and a goal.
Number 44 lining up, Gunnar Bright.
And number 9, Roland Rode. Wiper wins the faceoff. He's going to try to get a pass
right
there.
To the Rangers.
Oh, number 8 trying to get that puck, but can't connect. Number 20 is passing that. Blocked by Rangers.
Oh, couldn't really grab onto the puck. Now White Bears have it. Trying to pass it to number 18. Doesn't get there, though. Just goes to the bottom right. And it goes up into the air. Now on White Bears' side, number 20. Trying to shake
fighting
off number
15.
15.
Caden Speedle.
Thinks about White Bear has the puck.
Spider.
Trying to get it out of their zone.
Oh.
McKinnon. Looks like McKinnon just takes it out of their possession.
Trying to fight off number 18.
Trying to skate and juke and move and spin it all over around some players. And it just gets dumped down on the bottom left.
23. Trying to fight him, but number 17. Trying to get a pass off, but can't. Number 20 with the puck now. He's going to dump that. Trying to get a
that's
going to
be an icer. Now, this is the period where they've had most of their shots at. And they need to make those shots count, as they could have made this game a two.
Number 17 for the Rangers facing off Studier. And I believe number 5, Norman. Noah Norman. Really with the puck, takes a shot, but it's deflected. Hit behind the net.
No
it's
call.
It's going to cause him commotion. 10. Passing to number 6, gets tripped up on his own skates, but still handles the puck well. 6 on to number 10. Sachs is going to get that puck. He's going to pass it on to Willie, I believe. 25, skating into center ice.
We've heard his name a lot today in this third period.
Almost close to a breakaway there. Number 23 is going to pass that to Willie.
Blake Jacobson has been playing great today.
Now, number 7 for Wiper with the puck, skating onto left.
Trying to get past 2.
Number 11, fighting off these players. Trying to pass to number 4, but it is blocked.
And the goalie makes a nice save and just covers it.
Six minutes and 30 seconds left. Can the Rangers get some more goals, tie up this game, maybe bring it to overtime? 16 and number
6 minutes left in this third period. They would need a goal every 2 minutes or about. They really need to score fast. Rangers really fighting and trying their best.
17 is passing to number 3. Takes a shot.
Try to pass up to the middle there, but nobody there. 22, the hopper, trying to jump around some players again.
16 is going to pass.
Goes right 17. In between the legs.
Can't connect with the puck, though. 4, passing at 12. As 12 goes, trying to go to 16. 16 back with the puck, takes a shot, but it is blocked by a Rangers player.
It's wide left of the net.
Here we have number 8 trying to pass that. Can't connect with number 44, though, as 12 takes a pass to number 6.
A bit in front of him.
Here, number 44 now, skating up. Should have a pass, but can't, as it is poke-checked away. 12 tries to take a shot.
Takes a shot, but way high. As all players are fighting for the puck. Number 15 has it. Skating down the ice. Matching up with number 20.
27.
McKinnon getting in front. But doesn't get past two. And it goes right there. It's a breakaway.
Number 9. Can Sack stop it? And he.
And it was wide right.
Wide right. Right. Fighting behind the boards. Oh, fan on that shot with that pass. 27 with the puck.
Number 13 fighting. Looked a bit confused for a minute.
Number 9. Ugh. And that is gloved by Sachs.
As all the players are lining up for the face-off, it'll be on Rangers' side. Rangers only have about 4 minutes to get 3 goals. Can they do it? We'll have to see. Trust me, this has been a very long day for the Rangers, and I feel that if they do, it'll bring some energy back and liven up the people. And maybe get their first win. They still have not got their first win yet, so maybe they can come back.
Fighting in the corner. Number 7 with the puck. He's going to try to pass that as it goes into the crowd.
And somebody catches that one, and it goes right back on the ice.
Face
All
off.
Players lining up in the faceoff on Rangers' side.
White Bear wins that. Number 10's passing to 14.
Took a shot wide right.
Some big hits there. 15 trying to get that puck, but it's fighting number 6 and 14. 15 back with the puck. Tries to pass it to number 27, but 10 fights him off. 17 trying to pass that to McKinnon again, but it is dumped. 6 behind his own net, looking for some opportunities.
Just trying to waste some clock.
10 bounces that off. Bit of a hit there. As 6 tries to dangle them.
6 gets a little bit tripped up.
Now.
No call.
Number 15.
Rangers has it.
With
McKinnon pass to 18.
Back to 15. 22. Oh, but it's caught by number 8. And they can't connect. 4 in front of his own net. Skating towards center ice. Back to 8. Now to 18. 20. I think that was McKinnon. Get that puck, but it was missed by number 9. On the boards, 9 passes it, but it is dumped, and 12 has it for the Rangers.
Number 11 now.
Number 11.
We're a bit behind 21 as he goes right to 8, and he gets it. Trying to fight, trying to get through some legs, couldn't.
8 with the puck, dangling, passing with number 9, slap shot.
Shot,
block.
Big shot, good block too. Ooh. Oh.
The goalie's down.
Got the rebound.
The puck is loose.
9, take a shot.
Wow. Great recovery from the goalie there.
He looks like he fell down on his butt and was trying to get up.
Pass on his, off his own man. Fighting on the boards. Now number 4 has it. He's going to pass that.
And Rangers are changing their line.
18. Now I believe 11 has it. 2 with the puck. Trying to pass that is intercepted by the Rangers. McKinnon dumps that down as 25 is going to try to get that.
Number 17 trying to get this puck right now. Right along. Number 6 takes a hit.
Ooh.
Jeez. 2 players looking like number 2 and number 8 got a little hit there, and that. Back to that big crowd in front of the net. It looked like the puck
That's
got loose.
Nice
and got back.
Defensive play there.
Then takes a shot, and it was wide right because all the players in there.
A little more than 1 minute.
That'll be a penalty for the... A
little more than 1 minute left in regulation. As 13 Willie takes a shot on net but can't connect with it.
Sorry, there's going to be a penalty for... White Bear for charging.
Can they get another goal on this power play here? And then end the night off with at least something.
44 seconds left in the period.
This is not a great start to this power play for the Rangers here. As they're
cannot
still in
their get
own
it out
zone.
Of their zone. Number 12, spinning around some players. Back to McKinnon. McKinnon.
15 passes it, but can't connect.
Gets kind of tripped up there. No call by the refs. 20 seconds left in this period.
13. Skating into center ice. Trying to pass that to 15.
Spidell.
Off the shin guard of number 8.
10 seconds left.
Fighting for the puck. Number 6 has it.
And that will be the game for the Rangers and the White Bear
Big
Lake.
Big loss for Rangers. 2-5.
And... White Bear goes up to 5-2, and Rangers still trying to find their first win. They drop down to 0-5. They have not been playing very well this season, and they look to get their first win on Monday. Is it?
I believe so. And there's a huge, huge shot difference here with Rangers only having 11 shots and Wiper having 32. I mean, that's, I feel like a more offense work here with more shots on net at least.
Yeah, for the Rangers all together, they really just need to get together and get some shots and practice on passing the puck right, because they've had a lot of chances, but they haven't got those shots.
Yep. Same with defense. I mean, got to get that puck out of there. 32 against 11 shots is a huge difference.
Your announcers, Eli Graffelman and
Noel Peterson.
We will be signing off on this game against the Rangers and the White Bear. Well, hope you have a good night.